daughter and a couple of friends were driving around. The number one contender for the middleweight crown had no idea what kind of ship was about to go down. Till a cop pulled him over to the side of the road, just like the time before and the time before that. In Patterson, that's just the way things go. If you're black, you might as well not show. Story for the cops. Him and Arthur Dexter Bradley, they were just there prowling around. He said, I saw three men run out who looked like middleweights. They jumped into a white car with out-of-state plates. And Miss Patty Valentine just nodded her head. The cop said, wait a minute, boys, this one's not dead. So they took him to the infirmary. And though this man could hardly see, he told him he could identify the guilty man. One dying eye said, why'd you bring him in here for? He ain't the guy. Here's the story of the hurricane, the man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but one time you could have been the champion of the The ghettos are in flames. Reuben's in South America fighting for his name. And Arthur Dexter Bradley still in the robbery game. And the cops are putting the screws on him, looking for somebody to blame. Remember that murder that happened in a bar? Remember you said you saw the getaway car? Do you think you'd like to play ball with the law? Think it might have been that fighter that you saw running that night. Don't forget that you are white. The cop said a poor boy like you could use a break. We've got you for the motel job and talking to your friend at all. You don't have to go back to jail, do you? Be a nice fellow. You'll be doing society a favor. That son of a bitch is brave, getting braver. We wanna put his ass in stir. We wanna pin this triple murder. Just one punch, but he never did like to talk about it all that much. It's my work, he'd say, and I do it for pay. And when it's over, I'd just as soon be on my way up to some paradise where the trout streams flow and the air is nice, and ride a horse along the trail. But then they take him to the jailhouse where they try to turn a man. He never stood a chance. The judge made Reuben's witnesses look like drunkards from the slums. To the white folks who watched, he was a revolutionary bum. And to the black folks, he was just a crazy nigger. Nobody doubted that he pulled the trigger, though they could not produce the gun. The DA said he was the one who did the deed, and the old white jury agreed. Falsely tried. The charge was murder one. Yeah. guess who testified? Bellow and Bradley, and they both boldly lied. And the newspapers, they just went along for the ride. How can the life of such a man be in the palm of some fool's hand? To see him obviously framed couldn't help but make me feel ashamed to live in a land where justice is a game. They're free to drink martini and watch the sunrise, while Reuben sits like Buddha in a 10-foot cell, an innocent man in a living hell. That's the story of the hurricane, but it won't be over till they clear his name and give him back the time.